Welcome to Quick Tech News, where we keep you updated in the world of tech without wasting your time. Yesterday, Microsoft held an event to show off some of the new titles for its upcoming Xbox Series X console. A number of interesting titles were shown, from a new installment in the Fable series to Forza Motorsport, and perhaps most notably, Halo Infinite. Microsoft claims it will have a world that is twice the size of the ones from the previous two games. Something noteworthy here is that a number of the titles only mention support for the Xbox Series X and Windows PC. There was no mention of the current generation of consoles. This goes against what Microsoft has claimed, which is that they don't want to force you to purchase the newest console to run new games for at least 2 years. So either they went back on their word already, or games like Forza Motorsport, Fable, and some of the other games showcased won't be coming for a long time. It could also be the case that on launch they will only support PC and the Xbox Series X, and support for the older generation will come at a later date. Intel has announced more bad news. They've apparently encountered some issues with their upcoming 7-nanometer process, which will delay the next generation of chips. Intel has already been struggling for years to get their 10-nanometer chips onto the market, which they now have finally done, but AMD has already been pushing out their 7-nanometer chips for months. This means we may be stuck with 10-nanometer Intel chips for the next couple of years at least, whilst AMD is working towards 5-nanometer chips already. Historically, AMD has been known to be the CPUs that run hot and use lots of power, but right now the trend seems to be shifting the other way. Intel's current flagship Core i9-10900K runs very hot and uses lots of power with its 10 cores and 20 threads based on the 14-nanometer process. Apple co-founder Steve Wozniak is suing YouTube on the grounds that the platform has ignored his request several times to take down fake Bitcoin giveaways using his name. Wozniak has compared YouTube's action, or lack thereof, to the Twitter hack that happened last week when high-profile individuals' accounts were compromised and used to share a Bitcoin scam which caused many people to lose loads of money. YouTube claims to take reports of abuse on its platform very seriously, and according to its website, has taken down over 6 million videos and suspended over 2 million accounts in the first quarter of this year. With such an enormous amount of content being uploaded to YouTube every minute, no doubt many of these takedowns come from their own algorithms detecting misuse and violations.
We're just normal people, and we just have to go through that their whole process and figure out what you. They don't have a category that says report a crime so a human can look at it. And I don't think a human in YouTube ever saw what was going on here. I just don't believe it. We went to state police, and they got involved and got some information. But we just couldn't get to a human at YouTube.
But they must be on the ball with users flagging content as well, else they will open themselves up for more lawsuits in the future. If you enjoyed this video, I would really appreciate if you could like the video, subscribe, and tell your friends to help get this channel off the ground. Thanks, and see you next time.